Hello everyone. So there was a question about finding empty fields in Jira. Now this question is important because I'm sure a lot of you guys are struggling with this. Now when people use Jira, when let us say some teams are using Jira, they want to ensure that some fields are captured for sure, and that is why we have this option of creating a field mandatory, which is of course at the project level. You can also do validators, and there are a lot of other things that we can do to make a field required. Now it is not always possible to make a field required. Maybe you're using a project in a shared instance where maybe you have some recommendations from your Jira administrators that will not really create your own project specific scheme, for example, or maybe a workflow. This is totally normal, but in this case, of course, you're not really blocked. There are things that you can still do. Now, you cannot really stop people from not filling up the field, but you can definitely report on it. Now, this is a question from this user about how to identify those issues. Now, let me share a few things that I think can be done. Now, first of all, finding a field which is empty in an in your Jira instance or maybe within a project is as simple as writing a simple JQL. So a simple JQL like this, date pickup field is empty, will return actually all the projects, not just projects, issues where this field is not filled in, right? Or maybe you can do something like not empty. So if you do not empty, it will of course give you the issues where this particular field is definitely not empty, but we want to do the reverse. Now when you do this, you will probably get a lot of issues, 639, and it may not be relevant. And you just want to also add something like project is equal to Android or whatever. So basically this will limit it to your specific project. And again, even within Android project, we have a lot of issues. Maybe let me try iOS. I think I do have iOS project. So yeah, this is a good example. Now, what you can do is you can of course save it. Date picker empty. So this is of course your JQL which you have saved. And now you can do a lot of wonderful things. For example, if you go to the details, you can actually create a subscription. Let us say you want to be reminded every day, 9 a.m. or maybe before your stand-up call, that these are the list of issues where people have not really filled in the date field. And of course, this is just one simple query, but you can of course now do something else. Like maybe you can do current sprint. For example, if there is an issue in the current sprint or future sprint, and maybe you want sprint in, let us type here future sprint and current sprint, whatever. I think you understand. So basically the idea here is that you want to ensure that if the issues are relevant to you, maybe these issues are within your scope. It could be project, it could be sprint, it could be current sprint, it could be future sprint, or maybe upcoming sprint. Then you want to make sure the field is filled in. Now, when you go to your dashboard, you can also use, where is my dashboard? Jira Cloud. So when you click on the dashboard and when you go to the filter result, you can also modify this filter or basically add a gadget called, filter result. This is of course one of the gadget, and you can also, so now we have the list here. We can also do something like maybe you can create in your board, scrum board. For example, if I go to my scrum board, let us do that. For example, if I go to my iOS project, let us open one of the story, which is basically for my iOS project. And what I want to do is I want to basically look at the board, which is, let us say, backlog or whatever, active sprint board. So the good thing about your board in Jira or boards in Jira is that you have the option to create quick filters. For example, if you go to quick filters and if you type in the same JQL, empty date picker field add. So what will happen now, if you now go back to your board, you will then have a, let us say you're doing your daily standup. Of course, you are looking at your backlog or whatever view you're looking at. So the moment you select empty date picker field, it will filter this particular list and show you the issues where this particular field is indeed empty, and you can take action. You can maybe go to that particular issue, or you can actually ask people why this particular field is not filled in, something similar. I mean, the thing is that you don't have to do complex customizations all the time. You can do these simple, very simple things in Jira to not only get the information, but also ensure that you are looking at these reports to fix the gaps and things that are supposed to be filled in. And of course, we are doing it later. So I thought I'll probably show you, and I'll probably share how to do this thing in Jira without asking your Jira administrators. And that is it. That is all I wanted to talk about today. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and you learned something new. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.